Okay, and as I mentioned earlier, real quick, simplified supply chain system. So we have the suppliers, which provides the raw materials. This aligns with the one of the diagrams in the chapter where we have work in process. So work in process is your receiving, production, and inspection, and then distribution is your finished goods, and it goes out to the customer. Lead time, I want to bring it up because in some cases, lead time is measured differently. In some cases, a supplier views lead time as basically getting the raw materials to the point that they're finished with the product. Distribution sometimes views lead time as a product going from the supplier to be received from the distributor. And retailers usually view lead time as a time that the item is ordered. So we have the time that it's ordered until the time that the order is fulfilled. Okay. So lead time, when you deal with lead time of a product, I usually recommend that people view the entire chain as a lead time. What this does is this allows you to understand the effect of every section of this system. So if your time to go through a supplier is 7, and each of these is like 5, 5, 5, we'll just say make it for 15, so that's 22, and distribution is another 5, so 27. If it takes 27 days to go from the time that the product starts to be made to the time that it is received by the customer, then you can start to attack various parts of this to understand where we could decrease lead time. Unfortunately, a lot of these people do not like to talk with each other. So once again, you could replace receiving, production, and inspection with the manufacturer and a distributor and maybe a warehouse and then a distribution. You know, I use this as a model for organizations when I teach operations and how products go through an organization, but the same can be viewed from a systemic point for supply chains when you deal with multiple companies. Same theories apply. So in many cases, this stuff is masked. So maybe the distributor only knows the point that it is ordered to the point that it's fulfilled, which, okay, that may be all that they may be worried about. But what if you suddenly have a sudden change in your demand and you need to say, hey, supplier, we need our parts quickly? Well, if you try to move to a just-in-time system and the supplier is 7, that's the time it takes for him to go from raw goods to manufacturing. Well, you may say, hey, look, you know, I need products quicker. If you go such that they use up all their stock or all their strategies to get the product to you within 27 days, and they suddenly need to go faster than 7 days to get products created because they're running behind schedule or they didn't do a good demand forecast, all of a sudden you're going to see these ripples. And they usually start small and they get bigger and bigger until all of a sudden you, 20 days later, there's no product. Where's my product? Well, if you only worry about your part of the supply chain as it deals with lead time, you're setting yourself for failure. So later on, we're going to learn about relationships within a supply chain being very critical to the success of a supply chain. Once again, keep this in mind as we go forward. This is just provided to you to give you some ideas as some food for thought as we move forward. Once again, it's very difficult to get everyone to agree to this within a supply chain because as I mentioned earlier, organizational and multiple organizations find it very hard to agree and share information and work as a team. We're going to talk a little bit about Walmart later on in this class, and they're famous for beating up their suppliers. So suppliers suddenly are reluctant to work with Walmart, even though it's using their best interest to work with Walmart. So once again, keep this in mind. Okay, with that, there's obviously no questions because I'm here by myself. But if you do have any questions after watching this video, please feel free to post them in the general discussion section of our class. Or if you want to email me directly, please feel free. You're always welcome to do that. So without further ado, I want to thank you for your time in watching this. It's going to be about 40 minutes long after I clean it up. So once again, feel free to get a hold of me if you have any questions. I look forward to your comments. Take care.